What's going on, citizens of the universe? Back at it again with another live. Really enjoying these, and I'm hoping you're enjoying these too. Let's talk about a concept. Man, is this a total mindfuck? But really though, let's put some shit into context, okay? You see, we go on about our day, experiencing life through our mind, okay? You're watching me, but you're seeing me through your eyes. You're seeing me through your mind, through all the understandings, through all the obstacles, through all the pain, through all the adversity, through all the successes that you've experienced in your life. You observe me as you watch this video, right? And as I record this and I see myself, I'm perceiving myself through you, okay? Now, we're just seeing life through our mind. That whether you're a real estate agent, whether you're a mom, whether you're a dad, whether you work at a job, regardless of what you do in your life, you're experiencing it through you, through your mind. That if it wasn't for you, life wouldn't exist. So for that very same truth, you must be the most important speck of your life. Take a second to realize this. You are the most important entity. You're the most important being of your life. Why is it that we feel sometimes like we're subservient to others? Why is it that we feel so less than other things? Why is it that a fucking bill can make you feel small? Why is it that a friend or someone out can judge you and take away your most precious commodity? Is your life, is your mind, is the way you see yourself. You see, we're living in a world. It's a dual world. There's the real world. There's this wall that I could touch here. I can feel this beanie. Check it out, cool FC beanie. This is my logo for my real estate company, Gatto Real Estate, powered by Ambiance Realty. Shout out to Ambiance Realty. Great group of agents out in the LA area. I've moved my business to the Bay Area. So just a quick plug in. If you guys have any real estate questions, reach out to me. Now, we live in a world of just ideas, in a mental universe, and it's been written all throughout history that we live in a mental universe. That the life you live and the people that you know and the people that are of existence in your life only exist in your mind. You see, you can be in bed right now, no one's around. If I look around in my room, no one's here. It's just me and the universe I communicate to. Outside of that, I can think of somebody, but the minute I start to think about somebody or something, it's only existing in our mind, and we gotta be able to see our mind and see what's real. Now, why is it that a lot of us or you feel afraid of thoughts? Take a look at this. Isn't this a trip that you're literally afraid of some sort of ideas in your mind? That the minute those ideas come up, you start to feel an anxiety, a pressure, a tension. Pay attention. When there's inner tension, pay attention. Why is it that a fucking thought, an idea, can make you feel such resistances in your system? And what do most people resort to? It's like, no, I don't want to think about that. When you talk about death, people are like, no, don't talk about that. Don't say that. Like, bro, the same beauty that brings life to the world must be the same beauty that leaves life in its existence. It's all just one cycle. Death is a natural cycle. I don't resist death. I know that one day it's inevitable that everybody I love and everything I have is but of a temporary. It's a lease. We're all living on lease. Now, with this understanding, I can be proud of the life I live right now. I can fully accept everything that life grants me. Instead of resisting life, instead of resisting your mind, instead of resisting your heart hurting or your mind hurting or these ideas that limit us, instead of resisting these things, how about I just flow? How can I flow into the natural forces that are amongst us already? Ain't it absurd that right now, wherever you're at in the world, the planet is literally orbiting. We're spinning in a circle. We're orbiting the sun, that if we go even like fucking 2 meters, 5 meters closer to the sun, we'll all melt. If we go 2 meters, 5 meters away from the sun, we'll start to freeze. And out here in San Jose, California, it's freezing. Ain't that a trip? And here we are trying to control everything in our life. Trying to control things not to happen to us. Well, what if they do happen? What if they did happen, huh? Are you gonna live in an idea of ruins? Or are you just gonna fully accept, I want to participate? Look, let's take on the idea that when challenges arise in life, I'm gonna be the first to volunteer and say, hey, I'm up. Who's gonna do the challenge? I'll take it. I volunteer. Why? Why? Because I wanna take full ownership of my life. I'm here to take on the challenges of my life. I'm not here to resist them. I'm not here to be afraid of no challenge. I'm here to see what I'm about. So what is a life without its challenges? You see, you're trying to keep everything safe. Trying to keep your life safe. Trying to keep your identity safe. Protecting a little identity. Come on, man. The planets are orbiting. There's this natural force that when there's a drought, there's rain. And when there's a flood, you know, the sun comes out and absorbs everything. There's these natural healing forces in life, isn't it? Is it reasonable to think that, or is it reasonable to assume that if we didn't force out to life that nothing good would happen? You see, naturally, life is already healing itself. Life is naturally healing itself. We've been living in planet Earth for billions of years. Through every adversity, through every earthquake, through every storm, through everything, life heals itself. So instead of resisting the things of which could go wrong in your life, how about you say, hey, I'm just gonna volunteer to take on every responsibility in my life. I volunteer. I'm gonna take on every challenge, every responsibility in my life. Outside of my control, outside of my own natural will, I'm just gonna be a participant of the universe. I'm not gonna try and change if it's gonna rain today. I'm not gonna try and change because she flaked on me, because my deal didn't close, because I didn't make the money that I thought I was gonna make, because he should, but he said, blah, 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 blah. See, that's the mind. Tell it to just shut the fuck up with its agenda. Let me experience what's going on around me, and let me fully bask in the sweet ecstasy of my life. You see? Before we know it, this thing's gonna be gone, my friends. And the last thing you're gonna want is to live a life afraid of challenging yourself. A life afraid of seeing what you're made of. A life afraid of truly experiencing every fucking feeling, every array of emotion, every feeling, or everything that's possible in this life. And it's not just feelings. However, we run from feelings, we run from ideas. What if we just didn't resist anything? And that's the practice to take on. That's the video, right? Resist nothing. How about just try it as a practice? Today, stop resisting the things you're trying to resist from not happening. See everything as a challenge in your life. And if it's not a challenge, then reward yourself. Pat yourself on the fucking back. Why? Because you're doing the best you fucking can, all right? Life's too short to be in fears or in doubts or in anxieties and all these bullshit ideas that you're afraid of. I'm not gonna resist life. I'm gonna fully accept what I got to face today and see it as an opportunity to grow my character, to see what I'm made of, to see what my potential is. Because isn't that the truest art of life? Is to see what we become? Is to see and be the perfection of man? See, when I look at my life, I analyze, what would be the perfect fucking man? What would be the perfect representation of what mankind should be? And from there, now I have a filter of how to carry myself, how to make decisions, how to act of reason, how to logically understand my life, how to look inside and see what I'm feeling. If there's a resistance inside of me, let me analyze this resistance before I try to stop shit from happening to me. Let me just see what's going on. Let me feel this life. Let me not be afraid of this shit, okay? So that's it for this video. All right, guys, I got Tiger's Eye, Eye of the Tiger cardio boxing program. You can find it on my website. If you're looking for an at-home workout, boxing, movement, cardio, ultimate transformation to be in the best shape of your life, guaranteed, with a private community on Telegram, positivity, everybody sharing their wins, everybody sharing their transformations. Right now is the time to be around good people in this life. You see, you're resisting the people around you, resisting being in a positive environment just to bask in a world full of shit, okay? Look, in this life, you got to show up to the arena of life. But it's even better when you're around people who push you and thrive you by being the best examples of themselves, okay? All right, guys, that's it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed. Salute.